watching my video. So today I'm bringing you another amazing unboxing and review. This time the seller is someone that if you've been in the hobby for more than a day, or two, or three, you might have heard of them. They are Tampa Bay Cichlids. I have actually bought over 50, or pretty close to it, from Tampa Bay Cichlids, because about 3 months ago I sold all my stock and restarted with small fish. And Tampa Bay Cichlids, my local fish store Leo's Lagoon, were my main suppliers. So in my previous videos I mentioned about being able to deal with your customers as a supplier. And David from Tampa Bay Cichlids has dealt with me since the beginning, with like flawless customer service and communication, which is essential when purchasing fish online. Now my handy dandy tool here, helping me easily to open this box. Now as you saw on the 360 view, there was no damage done to the outside of the box. It is labeled, making sure the handlers understand there is live fish and to keep warm. The outside of the box was closed as normal with table around. And to tell you the truth, the only other shipper I've seen to do something different has been Queen's Fins, which he uses staples to close his boxes. So make sure you check his review. Here we see a little card and we see the instructions of what to do when you receive the fish, just in case you're new. And also has the invoice to make sure that your order is correct. Now it's a little dusty, but we could deal with that. Let's open this baby up. So as you see, the inside of the box is protected with this type of insulation. It has aluminum foil on the outside. This is to make sure that the outside elements stay out of the inside of the box as much as possible. Now I ordered 10 fish from them, this time all juvies, as I mentioned before. Now the fish are all back with this large plastic bag, which has some type of insulation inside. It looks like some type of cardboard, shredded, smashed. I don't know, I ain't no scientist, so correct me if I'm wrong, please. All I know is there is a bunch of this stuff. So here are the fish. Let's start showing you this fish. The first one is the otopharynx SP heterodon. A beauty. Next we have the Chitande Island peacock. Now he's one of the two peacocks that I got. Or should I say three? The lethrinops SP Bossy Creek. Then we have the red cap lethrinops Itungi. Now I haven't seen any of these fish out there a lot, so hopefully he grows out to be a beauty. And the blue orchid, the candy. From candy, actually. And we have an intermedius. Now this is a baby intermedius, not those beautiful big intermedius everybody be selling out there. And we have the Niagara flame tail. Now I have had bad luck with Niagaras. For some reason I haven't been able to grow them out, or they're females, so hopefully this time we get it right. Now I do dump the fish inside the water because it does have small particles and I don't want the fish to start munching on them. So now we have the blue dorsal from Undu Reef. Beautiful fish. And for some reason I got females. I mean, I don't even breed, so I don't know why I even decided to order females. Got a female bicolor 500 and I got a female red top blue Wanda. So they'll go with the juvies and probably will stay there with the juvies so that they don't make a World War 3 up in my tank later on. But we'll see. And as you see here, there is no water inside the box, which means nothing leaked. And the fish are good to go. No casualties, thank Lord. And here you see the fish in their bags, acclimating. Like I always do, I leave them there for about 30 minutes. Make sure they get that temperature adjusted from their bag to the temperature inside the aquarium. So now that the fish have been acclimating, they're gonna go into the fish tank. The first one that's gonna go in is the blue orchid. Now this is, I never done this before. I'm showing you the fish go inside the tank and showing you the picture as adults on the left side because they are kind of boring, they have no colors yet. The second fish is a Niagara, and like I said before, I have no good luck with these guys, so hopefully this one turns out to be what I am expecting, a beautiful Niagara male. This is a Chitande Island peacock. I don't know much about this fish, other than he does look pretty cool, so we'll see how it grows out to be. The next fish we have is the lethrinops in Bossy Creek. Now, I did ask David if he could pick out juvies that have egg spots, and that's what I'm talking about when I'm talking about good customer service. He did what I asked, and he tried to get all of them that he could with the Xbox. This is the auto heterodon, and there he goes. And most of the haps that I bought have those three little dots, so it's going to make it complicated for me to know which ones they are. This is the red cap lethrinops. I've never seen this fish as an adult, so I'm pretty excited about seeing him grow. This is the intermedius. You see him a lot. Whoa, look at him go. He's pretty popular, but we'll see him grow as well. Hopefully he can turn out to be beautiful like the rest. And this is the underreef, blue neon. It actually takes a while for them to color up, but once they get their color, they look amazing. Last, we have both the females, the Luanda and the Bicolor 500 going in. Well, folks, overall, I would definitely recommend Tampa Bay Cichlids. They have great customer service, a wide variety of fish to select from, and the best website out there, in my opinion, to buy African cichlids from. They do offer free shipping with any purchase over $49. Hope you enjoyed this video, but most important, have a great rest of your day.